I have the honor and privilege to have Shaykh Rashied Matthews, spiritual advisor from Al Hafiz Mosque and Community Center located on 75th and St. Lawrence. He is in the studio right now, and we want to bring this brother into the conversation and really relinquish the floor to him. Okay.
As-salamu alaykum.
Wa alaykum as-salam.
A'udhu billahi min shaitan rajim. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Manager Sultan and Aulia. Brother Kendall, the reason what I just did was what most of us have forgotten about. It's just like the oxygen that gives life to our bodies. The Creator gives power to our souls. So what I did was just connect to my soul so that what I say comes from my heart with sincerity, and I'm able to go bypass the minds of human beings that are diverse with different frame of references and go to that part of them that's connected to everything. And it is a traditional means that we have actually lost as a people. And I think as we begin to conversate, I want to be able to articulate a method that most of us have lost. And because we have lost that kind of communication and method, it was a method that the Moors used when they conquered Spain. It was called mystical chanting. It was nothing mystical about it other than the fact that they were able to, like a yogi who was able to take deep breaths and give power to their body and maybe dive belly wop from maybe 100 yards up in the air into a small pool and don't even harm themselves. The same token, by invoking the Creator through his holy names, it gives power to a soul of human beings to be able to decipher and distinguish, you know, what is real and what is not real.
Yes, sir. And with that being said, you have the floor.
Oh, alhamdulillah. Thank you, sir. I really appreciate you. And I remember when I met you before, and you were on stage, and it was an immediate connection. I knew that this person was a very, very powerful spiritual person that was frustrated with the what was happening in our society. Well, one thing, Brother Kendall, we have to realize is that we are souls with bodies. Our bodies are not us, and we're not our bodies. But the soul, there is a diet that to nourish our souls. And if it's nourished properly, it's going to be healthy. The same thing with our body. If we don't, and you look like a very healthy guy to me. You look like you eat right, you sleep right, you try to take care of yourself. If you were a junk food eater and you tried to work out, you wouldn't have the strength. So the nutrition that you are putting in your body is consistent, and it's helping your body. So that's because you have knowledge about that. Well, the same token with this part of us, and we're not going to, just for the sake of argument, I'm not going to put a title on it. I'm not going to debate theology or religiosity. I'm saying we are souls with bodies. And so that's everybody that's a Christian, a Jew, a Muslim, a Republican, a Democrat, an independent, anyone who has a value with their existence and they understand how to keep themselves healthy, they're going to draw from that that's going to make them healthy.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. And again, I continuously say the floor has been relinquished to you, Shaykh Matthews. And the reason for it is because we have people from around the country who are on our airwaves.
Yes.
Right now, we're average. Just so that you know the premise behind it.
Yes.
250,000 at minimum right now are listening to your words.
Yes.
And I would discredit it trying to say anything or ask you anything specific than other than what I want to ask you, which I will do.
Okay.
But I want to afford those who are listening
yes, sir.
To understand where you draw from. they can get a premise from it.
Well, you know, one thing about it, if you had a car and you bought a brand new car, no matter what car you had, you wouldn't take it to a bicycle shop to have it maintenance. So, and this is what we're doing. We're actually taking our cars to bicycle shops and trying to get a maintenance. Even though we get a paint job or we get some new wheels or some new sparks or wash it up, it's still not going to be a maintenance car that you intended to buy in the first place. So we're not drawing from the knowledge and the direction that our Creator. I don't know why people are scared to talk about the Creator. And, you know, to take the Creator out of life is like taking the oxygen out of your body. So you have to be really, really ignorant or don't have a clue about you, who you are and whose you are, to start a day without breathing. So this is the method that 124,000 prophets came to mankind. All the prophets were born through a woman, and they actually represent the best in us. And there is, and it goes all the way back, Brother Kendall, goes all the way back to, because we are spiritual beings having a physical experience. We're not physical beings having a spiritual experience. So why would 124,000 prophets come to humanity and say, look, turn to that part of you that is the greater part of you? And so theology came through the prophets to try to define that and to break that down. But there is an entity that does not have our interests at heart. And it starts all the way back in Genesis. During the time when we call him Azazel, he became Satan after he rejected to bow down to Adam, whom the Creator had blown in him his spirit, which gave him the names and nature of all things. So that was his teacher. Before then, Azazel was created from a smokeless fire called jinn. Some of the listeners are probably very, very familiar with jinn.
Yep.
Some of them probably worship jinn. So, but the jinn were very, very powerful on earth, and Azazel, who was the leader of the jinn, he used to prostrate and pray all over on the earth, everywhere. The angels were very, very impressed with him, and so they asked the Creator. They referred to the Creator as Allah, meaning all in one and one in all. See, no one is it's an Arabic word that means one and all in one. It's not a separate entity like another state or another automobile. It is everyone, and that's why I say that everyone that's born through a mother has a soul. So, and that part of the Creator is in all of us, and this is why we have to respect everyone. But there's a method, Brother Kendall.
Yes, sir.
Of bringing that out. And this is what the problem is.
And this is what we want to talk about when we get back.
Yes, sir.
Ladies and gentlemen, 591-1690 is the number. We're going to take some calls. We are live in the studio. Brother Shaykh Rashied Matthews, spiritual advisor, Al Hafiz, the Mosque and Community Center, 75th in St. Lawrence. We're going to open up the phone lines. Let's have a conversation. Why are we in the predicament that we are in, and why is the community still killing each other? It's a WVON.
The next generation of WVON. Kendall Moore will be right back on the Talk of Chicago, 1690 WVON.
Everybody's talking about the good old days, the good old days. Everybody's talking about the good old days. I remember when me and my brothers, we used to sit up on the porch in the summertime and just talk about just making it, you know what I'm saying? Being successful, following after our dreams, you know. And I believe that's every kid's dream, you know what I'm saying? To rise and be somebody, but damn, sometimes we just get caught up.
I ain't got no money. Got no friends. Looks like my world is coming to an end. No food on the table, no clothes on my back, no shoes on my feet, and I just barely got a used Cadillac.
Now ain't that ghetto for ya? But somehow it's got to change, yeah. Ghetto for ya. So I took this
25 minutes after the hour, www.von.com. We are also on iHeartRadio. It's the Kendall Moore Show. The honor and pleasure of having Shaykh Rashied Matthews, spiritual advisor, Al Hafiz Mosque and Community Center, located on 75th and St. Lawrence. He is live here in studio, dropping knowledge. And we're here. We're always searching for answers. We're always looking for what are solutions to some of the madness that's going on, not just here in the city of Chicago, but just among our own communities, ethnicities, communities of color, comprehensively. It's not just happening here in the city of Chicago. When I'm talking to one of my colleagues in New York, Al Sharpton, or one of his National Action Network folks, or out in L.A., it matters not. But right now, here in the city of Chicago, we are at astronomical proportions when it comes to the blatant killings that are happening. Shaykh Matthews, again, we certainly appreciate you being here. There are a number of callers on the line wanting to have a conversation with you. But I want to just pose that to you before we get into it, because we are on radio. And so we want to make sure. Excuse me, Mike, we got these mics on. This one right here. Thank you. Apologies. We want to make sure that we have that conversation, because we're always looking for solutions to it. Everybody is talking about it, from McCarthy to Rahm to Father Flager to the Honorable Minister Elijah Muhammad. We have you sitting here. What say ye?
Well, you know, assalamu alaikum again, brothers and sisters. You know, I'm going to say some things to you that you may not have heard before, but, you know, this is something that I've been looking at since I was 3 years old. Right now I'm 65. So, you know, I've learned that over the years that the Creator, we are a creation of a Creator. But more importantly, when He created us, He created the creation part of us is like our ego. And when He created the ego, He told the ego to come forward, and it went backwards. He told it to go backwards, and it came forward. So He asked the ego, who am I? The ego says, I am me and you are you. So He put the ego in fire for about 1,000 years and brought the ego out and asked the ego, who am I? The ego says, I am me and you are you. Then He put it in freezing temperature for another 1,000 years and brought the ego out. And He asked the ego, who are you? He says, I am me and you are you. Then He made the ego to fast for 1,000 years. And brought the ego out. And the ego says, there's no God but you. So this is the premise that I want to actually build from, because I think that once we really understand ourselves, it's like, say, if you were a mechanic, you can't fix a car unless you understand the mechanics of being a mechanic and understand that automobile. And the person, when they leave, they have a maintenance manual, but someone who actually have built that car, they can actually maintenance that car mm-hmm. from the ground up. So I think that we have actually lost out on how to maintain ourselves. And so here we are. We are growing up, becoming as kids. I mean, you know, kids, they say kids are real naughty and they bad and all that. But actually, this is the part of the child, their ego, that's rebellious, that have not yet been trained, and most of us don't know how to train the ego because our egos are not trained. Mm. So, you know, you get this rebellion, and that's all human beings. You know, if you're going into a church, you're going to a synagogue, you're going to a mosque, you're going to a temple, you're black, white, you're red, yellow, brown, you're a Democrat, you're a Republican, you're independent. If you're out of control, you're out of control. You know, there are certain things, that's why they have it politically being correct. You know, some people say some things that are just off the wall. Why did they say those things? You know, a lot of times they don't understand why they say them. And so therefore, to spend our time trying to find out why somebody said something, think about ourselves. See, we have enough in ourselves to get ourselves together. You cannot give nobody a ride if you got a flat tire. I don't care how much you say get in your car, you can fill your car up. But if you have a flat tire, you cannot give anyone a ride. So it comes back to us. And that's why I say I don't, you know, even as a Muslim, I don't get into people's theology. I look for sincere people. I look for people with good hearts that have common sense and a rational mind. So therefore, we can talk because we can learn when your heart is open. It's like I was saying earlier when I sought refuge in the Creator against the cursed devil. You know, they say that the furthest distance in the universe is from the earth to the universe. But the greatest distance, Brother Kendall, is from your mind to your heart. Mm. And we are messed up.
Yep.
And so we don't know why we messed up, see?
Yep.
And we don't know how we messed up. Because the messed up people are so messed up and that they're messing everybody up, you know. So we come from all kinds of diversities. I mean, all kinds of abuses, man, all kind of disrespect. And so we're out here. And just to go back for a while, you know, we are the offspring of those who were on the ship that was taken from the continent.
Shaykh, I need you to hold that thought.
Okay.
Can we pick that back up as soon
as we can? Oh, absolutely. No doubt.
Folks, don't touch the dial.
We're about to roll, sir.
You see, he never smiled.
Broken home. 34 minutes after the hour, www.von.com. It's the Kendall Moore Show. Davita Flute, she pays for it. Alonzo Stallings, how are you, sir? My associate producer. Listen, big shout to my man Cliff Rome. I want to remind everyone, Cliff Rome is doing his thing over at his restaurant. It is his one-year anniversary. Make sure that you get there. Listen, today from 6 until 9 p.m., it's not too late. The address is 4655 South on King Drive. Come celebrate his first-year anniversary. Gourmet bites, petite sweets, $1 craft beer samples, and live music. Chef Cliff Rome. He's here at WVON each and every Wednesday. You can check him out. But get over there right now, 4655 South on King Drive. Call us. We're going to get to you in just a second. But in the meantime, when a teacher is teaching, you shut the hell up. And we're going to get to the callers in just a second. The honor and pleasure of having Shaykh Rashied Matthews, spiritual advisor, Al Hafiz, the mosque and community center located on 75th and St. Lawrence. He is here live in studio, and it's an honor to have him here. If you could pick it up.
I'd like to say salamu alaikum again to all the beautiful souls out there, all the souls. We are souls and we're not bodies, and I want to give peace to everyone's soul. I was speaking before we went off air about we are the descendants of those who were brought over here on the ship. But more than that, we are the descendants of the slaves that were actually landed and were here, and they were divided and conquered by the Willie Lynch letter. Now, a lot of you may not know about the Willie Lynch letter, but you have to understand that we go back all the way to the Garden of Adam and Eve, when Azazel, who later became Satan, tricked our parents out of felicity, saying that if they bit from this apple that the Creator told them not to bite from, that they would have eternal life and they would be able to see things and be things that they would never dream that they could become. But before that could happen, Satan had to have a division between our mother Eve and our father Adam. So we come back. To the Willie Lynch letter. This is still a method for division, dividing and conquer. Now, whose interest was it in for us to be divided and conquered? Now, you know, people might say, "Well, okay, the white man is okay." Well, you know, all right, but there are some black people that have abused, that have been abused,
yes,
and abusing their daughters and their sons,
yes,
and you had relatives and all of that. So when you start saying that, you start putting the devil in a shape and a form and a color, then he's convinced us that he doesn't exist because we don't know where he is. So One thing about you have to understand that we don't understand is that the devil works through everyone. One of the prayers that one of the prophets used to make, Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, he used to say, "Oh Allah, please do not leave me in the hands of my ego for a blink of an eye or less." Prophet David also used to make the same prayer, because that part of us, that ego that we spoke about earlier, that's rebellious, that has to be trained, and that's the whole point of worshiping. This is why I don't get into theology with people. I mean, if you believe in something good, if it's making you, helping you to be a good person, want for your brother, sister what you want for yourself, help your neighbor, and you're sincere and good, hey, that's a good religion. And I'm not going to debate you. And it's not in a building. It is in you. You know, one thing about Esau ibn Maryam, a lot of you don't know that Esau ibn Maryam, that's his Arabic name, is really the son of Mary, Jesus Christ. He said, seek ye first the kingdom of heaven through righteousness. What was that? Righteousness, fighting everything, putting his ego in check so that he would realize that, or to see that that was not of his true being. And he said, where is the kingdom of heaven? He said, it's within. So he said, be in the world, but not of the world. Why? Because we are not from this world. We are paradise people in a physical body, experiencing and learning about ourselves and our creator in ourselves. We have the ability to conquer anything. Why do you think 124,000 prophets came to humanity and threatened us with hell? Not hell once you die and go to hell, but hell through the lack of guidance and understanding of our physical nature and our spiritual nature. And this is what we're not getting that. They're not teaching it in the schools. And a lot of our leaders, they don't understand that. You have to understand. In the Quran, Allah says in the Quran, if all the oceans were ink and all the trees were pens, never would you exhaust the words of Allah Almighty, meaning that the solutions are endless. It's endless. There are so many words and so much wisdom, it's endless. So why don't we have the solutions? Why don't we have the solutions to our problems? Because really, we're really not looking for them, because we really don't believe that there is a solution.
591-1690, that is the number. Shaykh Rashied Matthews from 75th and St. Lawrence. It's the Al Hafiz Mosque and Community Center. Let's go to the phone lines and see what the people are thinking and have a conversation with them. Will, how you doing? Welcome to the Kendall Moore Show. Will? Will, going once.
Where you at, Will?
Do you hear me?
Hey,
do
Will. Hey, Brother Will, how you doing?
All right, can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you now.
All right, Ken. Good evening to your guests and to the VON family. To your guests, I've never seen you before, never even heard of you before, but 80% of what you said, I said to a person no more than 3 days ago. I have two questions for your guests.
Yes, sir.
The one question is, since we are souls inside this body, where did the souls come from before they entered this body? And the other question is, once this body cease to function right, or die, as we say, where do the souls go? Are we trapped in this dimension eternally? I'll hang up and listen.
Thank you, Will.
That is an excellent question, man, and it shows that not only you are a scholar, but you are a gentle soul. Yes, sir. You know, there's a verse in Quran that says, from Allah we come and Allah we shall return. When you go back into the garden, it was when, Adam was created from mud, and then the creator blew of his spirit in Adam. That was part of the soul of the creator, the attributes of doing good, the attributes of power, the love. These were the essential attributes that Adam possessed, and that's why he told Azazel, who later became Shaitan, to bow down to. It wasn't that he was bowing down to the mud. He was bowing down to those attributes that was of God. And so before we even came, say, okay, during that time, that was that time. But before we come here, we on the Day of Promises, that's when all souls were gathered together. Our souls are from the realm of souls. And we are paradise people. And so the Creator brought us all together, and we all promised that we would always be obedient servants to our Lord. Nobody knew that he was going to test us and send us here in the human form to take on ideologies and religions and these different shapes and forms of the human beings. Those are veils. Those are veils. So the prophets came to say that there is something in you that's connected to everything. And that's what Jesus Christ was saying. That's what he told the people. He says, fight everything that's not of you. And then you reach the kingdom of heaven. All things will be given unto you. He's telling them, you got to go back to that soul, that part of you that's connected to the Creator, that, you know, that when you reach that, then all things will be given unto you. Well, the hell came in. Okay, Brother Kendall, go ahead.
No, Brother Shaykh, I don't mean to interrupt you.
Go ahead.
I want to get to, how do we change the madness? Because, you know, we can give the historical context from it. How do we begin to change the mindsets of those who may be lost? And let's speak more like to right now.
Okay.
How do we get people more involved with, let's say, your mosque and or the community center? How do we stop some of the things that are going on inside of people's homes when, you know, you have just multiple high-risk behaviors that are taking place?
Okay, he's talking about the contemporary things, but I'm in the present continuous. This is something that goes on, Brother Kendall. This is not,
yes, sir.
This is not something of the past. I'm not talking about tales of the ancients. And this is why I said this conversation is a conversation that hasn't been had because we don't have a frame of reference for it. It sounds like it's something that may be far off, but the Creator says that I'm closer to you than your jugular vein. And so this is the present continuous, you know. So the thing is, what you're saying, the question of what you're saying is very, very simple in that once a person begins to understand who they are and whose they are, their behavior begins to change. Like we do something in terms of a lot of the, when we go into a lot of the youth, when they come to the mosque, we put them in like a meditation. Meditation, and what we do is that we start to invoke their spiritual power from within them. To invoke something, doesn't that mean it's not a passive thing? It's like I might say, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan Abdul Rasulullah. I'm invoking something in you that's in you, that's been hidden, that's there, that if it was not with you, you could not even look at me, Brother Kendall. You wouldn't have the intelligence that you have. You wouldn't have the ability to eat the proper foods and go work out. You wouldn't be able to think about maybe a TV show when you leave here. So that is in the present continues. That's all of us. We're not in tune to that, and we don't know how to reach that. But this is why, you know, the prophets were saying to the people, be still and know that I'm God. See, not the physical part, because that ego, that part of us, it's like a horse. A horse, an untrained horse, will do anything. But how do you train that horse? You definitely cannot train that horse with a whip. The way you train that horse, you come up and you keep your hand and put some sugar in the hand, and once that horse bends over and start to lick the sugar out of your hand, you can put a bridle on that hand and you can calm that horse down by rubbing that horse. See, we have a fear of ourselves, therefore we throw off that fear among other people. There is a flower in India that it has the power of attraction, but around that flower there are many scorpions and snakes. So you just can't go up in there unless you are feeling peaceful enough that those scorpions and snakes do not fear you. A wild dog will bite you if you have a fear of it. So the thing is that we have to calm out, be still, and know that I'm God. In other words, that part of us that's connected to everything is what we're missing out on. And once a person is taught how to reach that, they're going to have a different mindset. It's like I said earlier. I said the furthest distance that most people think about is they're thinking it is from the earth to the furthest galaxy. But the greatest distance in is from your mind to your heart.
Yeah, yeah.
So we have to reconnect that. There's a method for connecting that. And if we were connecting that, if we had a method, if I had facilities, and the media, man, this is great. Be able to get into the people's head. Because Satan is into the heads all the time. He's saying to them all the time what they're not and what they should do and what they should not do and what they're not. They beat as a beatdown, constant beatdown, 24/7. So they take that on, and so they begin to treat each other that way. And so it's easy to lose your value of self. So therefore, it's easy to lose value for someone else. So we have to come back to ourselves in a real way.
Brother Shaykh Rashied Matthews, spiritual advisor, Al Hafiz, the mosque and community center. It's located on 75th and St. Lawrence. For those of you who are just now joining us and you may not be familiar with what his work and not even just his work, but the worth of what he is delineating this evening. He works with high-risk youth, summer camp, and groups for young men and women who are coming home from jail and or prison. We are going to take a couple more calls, and then I am giving the floor back to Brother Matthews. 591-1690, that is the number. Adrian, how you doing? Welcome to the Kendall Moore Show.
Oh, hi. I'm doing all right. I was calling. I just caught part of it, but I was calling because I was disagreeing what he was saying, because the Bible was clear that when Adam and Eve, when they partook, you know, Eve was deceived. However, Adam, he's her head. He was not deceived. And that's why they didn't know they became blind. It's after he ate, because he's the head of the family. And then it's, everyone knows that Satan is real. 1 John 5:19 helps us to appreciate he's the ruler of the system. And that's why we need to pray for God's kingdom that Jesus told us to pray for. And in the book of James, it helps us to see that we are being drawn out and enticed by our own desires. So God, he determines what's right and what's wrong, but we are free moral agents, and we just choose to do right or wrong. And so you really can't say that people don't have the knowledge. People choose not to have the knowledge, and those that even have the knowledge still choose to do what's wrong. So it's all raised on an individual basis.
That's right. I appreciate that, sister. Pray for us.
All right.
Listen, we're back in a moment. We will wrap up when we get back, folks. Stick around. It is the Friday Night Show. Four minutes after the hour, www.von.com. Chef Cliff Rome, it's still going on, folks. From 6 to 9 p.m., make sure that you are out there, 4655 South on King Drive. Cliff is here at WVON every Wednesday night. His show begins at 9 p.m. Tonight, he's at one of his many restaurants. Again, 4655 South on King Drive. It is come and celebrate his first year anniversary, Gourmet Bites, Petite Sweets, $1 craft beer samples, and live music. Go on out, join him. I may join him after I leave here this evening, but I want to make sure that you are supporting that brother. Also, go to WVON.com and check out our latest video, President Barack Obama the full Democratic National Convention speech. And while you are there, go to our website, WVON.com. And now that both the Republican and Democratic National Conventions have ended, are you eager to cast your vote on November 6th? A for yes, B for no. With that being said, as we get ready to wind down with Shaykh Rashied Matthews, from Al Hafiz Mosque and Community Center, 75th and St. Lawrence. You know we're going to have him back. He's also in the documentary, The Interrupters, alongside his wife, Amina Matthews. Many of you know her work with Ceasefire in the streets, Inglewood, Roseland, and other high-risk neighborhoods. Sheikh, I want to give you at least 2 minutes to give me your closing comments, but let me ask you this question. The Democratic and the Republican National Convention, they've ended. You know, they say, you know, Muslims do not get involved with elections. And so my question to you, should black folks be involved in the electoral process?
Oh, you know, the reason I vote is because my family, my ancestors died for the right to vote. And for the respect of them, I do, but I don't look to anything other than that one who created me to whatever it is I need to do so I can do what I need to do to do what I need to do.
Yes, sir.
But I think that to be excited about something is good. I think people mobilizing and talking to each other is a good start. To believe in something, it's better to believe in something than to believe in nothing, because if a belief brings about a hope. And when that hope is it's built upon, and it takes you to another conversation. Maybe you start listening to something that you haven't listened to before. Maybe you start to say things that you never said before that you wanted to say. You know, maybe those pains and those inferiorities and those doubts begin to talk to a stranger about things, and they may have a solution. That's what we're all about. It's about wanting for your brother and sister what you want for yourself and treating your brother and sister the way you want to be treated, man. And, you know, just be a kind, good, sincere people, and good things will happen for you, man. You know, people saying that all good things come to end. Can I curse for a minute?
Oh, hell yeah.
Bullshit. Good begets good. Bad things coming to an end.
Shaykh Rashied Matthews, ladies and gentlemen. Listen, the website, I want you to make sure that you visit the website. It's www.masjidalhafizinc.com. Again, it's www.masjidalhafizinc.com.
I'm not a holy man, just a real man.
Brother Matthews, thank you so very much for your time and being here this evening, sir.
Thank you so much, Brother Kendall. I mean, you are a gentleman, a scholar, man. You are a beautiful brother, man. And I pray that Allah Almighty continues to raise you up and put your voice out there, man, because people need to listen to you, brother. You're a real brother. You are concerned about our people, the little people. And I don't care how big you get, I see you still dealing with the little people, taking from the little big people, bringing to the little people, bringing the little people up, and bringing the big people down. You the man, Brother Kendall. Thank you so much. I'm honored to be on your show, man. Thank you so much.
And you know you will be back. Thank you so very much. Make sure that you, when you go to the website, you can donate. Let's help these high-risk individuals in Inglewood, Roseland, and other high-risk neighborhoods. Again, the website, www.masjidalhafizinc.com. It gets no better, folks. It's the Kendall Moore Show. When we get back, Jenks Morton, he has a new movie coming out. We will talk with him from Washington, D.C. Friday nights are never the same. Hit the Facebook page. It's Kendall Moore or The Kendall Moore Show. The Twitter is Kendall_Moore1698.